मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, एम आई ऑडिबल? एनीवन कैन गिव अ रिप्लाई इन चैट बॉक्स? एम आई ऑडिबल? ओके, थैंक यू हर्षिता, थैंक यू सो मच. सो आई एम डॉक्टर गीता, प्रोफेसर सीएससी. And I am also a woman scientist under Kiran IPR. Today's section we are going to see context-free grammar. So it's a part of theory of computation subject, and it falls under unit 3. And today we are going to see context-free grammar. Before that context-free grammar, we are going to see what is grammar and what are the how to define grammar. After that we'll go detail into context free grammar. A small recap about the terminologies used in context free grammar. So I'll go for a chat box. Anyone can type what is a symbol. What is symbol? Students, feel free, and this is like not testing you under, just to refresh. What is symbol? Anyone can type. So far you have seen two units, so I want to some terminologies has to be refreshed. What is symbol? No one is there. Am I audible? Am I audible? Please type it in chat box. Yeah,
ma'am. Once again, okay. Ma'am, Gayatri, are you there? Gayatri. Gayatri, irkiya pa?
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Irukra, ma'am.
Oh, pasanga ta konjam info pannunga pa. Reply panna sollunga illa edhaavadhu sollunga. Ena ma'am ta new ah irukra, ma'am. Reply pannama irukka pora. அவங்க சொல்லிட்டு சொல்லுங்க.
ஆமா, chat box ல பண்ணிட்டு இருக்காங்க மேம். இதுக்கு பண்றாங்க, question க்கு தான் answer பண்ணல மேம்.
ஓகே
மேம். ஓகே மேம்.
ஓகே. Just guess what is symbol, right? Anyone can give out what is symbol. So far you have seen through, no? You can google it also, tell that same thing only. The input given to find it automata. Thank you Sanjay Charan, thank you so much. A symbol can be alphabet, letters, okay, which is finite. Symbols are set of character, right? Very good. Akash, thank you. Vignesh, thank you so much. Okay, let me see what exactly the definition is, right? A symbol is in a mark or sign or word that indicates some representation, right? Maybe an object or an idea, right? That you should remember it. So it is going to indicate something, right? So next question is, what is alphabet? What is alphabet? You can type it, nothing wrong, right? What is alphabet? Symbol can be alphabet, letter, which is finite. Vignesh, already you mentioned alphabet. Can you please tell what is alphabet? It's just a discussion class, yeah, nothing here. I had also learned from books and everything in there. You are not born with POC, right? A finite set of symbols, very good. Kaushik, thank you so much, right? So it is denoted as a symbol. That symbol, can anyone name? What is that symbol? I had represented that symbol now. We'll have three similar symbols in that, right? So the first symbol I had represented, you know, because people will get confused about it. So can you please tell what is that symbol? Type it in the chat box. What is that symbol? Alphabet, and here alphabet I had mentioned one symbol, right? What is that? And you people are very good at math, so you know easy, right? I am very good at programming, so I'm weak in math. Can you please tell what is that symbol? Because you should know it. Without that symbols and notations we cannot go. Summation, yeah, sigma, Kirtana, you are exactly right. Sorry Swati, better luck next time. So Kirtana, it is in TOC, it is called a sigma. Right, alpha is alphabet is represented in the term of sigma, right? Thank you Swati. So alphabet is in a finite set of symbols, right? It is in a set, right? A group of symbols will be presented there. So next, strings. What the strings. Who's going to be next? Sorry for joining late. Not at all a problem, Nandini. Next time you join at the right time. So what are strings? What is string? Anyone can answer. Yeah, I am not going to give any gifts or nothing, right? It's just in a discussion about your terminologies. That's it. A collection of character. Very good, right? A little change, Karthik Raj, a small change. Yeah, right, Sweta is corrected. A sequence of characters. Thank you. A finite sequence. Very good. Exactly, you formula into the thing. A sequence of symbol, right? A sequence is an countable, so that it is given as finite sequence. Vignesh Jay, very good. Sanjay Charan, words formed using symbols. Thank you so much, right? So exactly you got the definitions. So a string is a finite length sequence of symbol. The last 10 question, right? These are the four terminologies you should know before getting into contextual grammars. What is language? Sanjay Charan, shall I take language as the same thing, words formed using symbols? What is language? And you are Googling and typing, huh? Yeah, yes, sir. Yes. Right? A little definitions has to be respectfully defined that, right? So, slightly modified, what it is? What is it? What is language? What is language in theory of computation? What is language? Anyone? A finite set of non-empty string. Ram Raghav, the language is containing only one string. Empty strings, finite set of non-empty. Maybe an empty string will be present in a language. Ram Raghav, can you please modify your definition? Little bit. You search it and tell. Not at all a problem. That you have to know the four terminologies whenever people will ask, right? Even for your gate exams or interviews, they will ask, right? What is a language? How to define a language? How to define a string? How to define a symbol? Right? Everything. So, what is language? We'll go. There is not an crisp answer. I got it. So, a language is set of strings. People, please remember. Students, please remember. It's a set of strings, right? And it is from the same alphabet. That also you should know, right? It belongs to the same alphabet. That you should remember, right? Language is set of strings. But the strings belongs to the same alphabet, right? So, today's four, I think, important terminologies we have revised. Symbol, an alphabet, right? Finite set of symbols. Strings, finite length of sequence symbol, right? And languages, a set of strings, but it is belongs to or I can say a collection of strings here. But all the strings are belongs to the same alphabet, right? So with an examples, we'll see now. Is that clear? Type it in the chat box. Is that clear? Do you have any doubts? Is that clear? Students, please type it in the chat box. We don't want to bore these classes, right? We want to utilize in a nice way. Kirtana, thank you so much, right? It's merely going to be in a discussion, and I know that young generation are better than us, right? So it's merely in a discussion, right? So just in a CVL example, we can clearly understand. I am going to take a string, right? Finite sequence of symbols taken from an alphabet, right? Sigma. So see an example. I had created my alphabet, my language is containing, right? My sigma is containing A, B, C, D. These are the symbols, right? And the string from that alphabet, created as C, A, B, C, A, D. Any strings you can create. And similar way, if I am putting all the strings together and within a flower braces, then it is called as in a language. Is it clear? A is in a symbol, right? And A, B, C, D is in an alphabet, right? And C, A, B, C, A, D is in a string. Similar way, you can create cab, cat, like that. So many strings you can create that all strings put together is called as in a language. Is that clear? Yeah, Karthik Raj, thank you so much. Right? So it's in a binary alphabet. Can you please type the chat box any binary string? It is an easy question here. It is an easy question. Binary string. 01, very good, Rakesh. 0001, there is no space, right? Empty string is also there, right? Maybe Steven, Sanjay Charan, very good. Swati, thank you. The repeated names only I am seeing, right? What about other people? People, please, there that I don't know about other subject, but POC is nothing. Lifetime, the subject knowledge is required for you whenever, wherever you are going. So please be considerate, and that is more important, you should know about grammar and languages, right? Thank you, Nandini Sindhuja, Karthik Raj, JD. Okay, thank you, Swati, again. So I have taken a string 010101, right? The length of the string is 6. Those things and all you are already familiar with that. So I'm going for an next section. So now we are going for an grammar. I just will put it right in so far you had came across the name word grammar. So what is grammar? Just you type it, right? Almost you people are in third year, almost last 15 years, maybe last 10 years, you every time you will come across the word grammar. So what is grammar? Just an interactive session, sir, or else it will bored, right? From morning 5 hours or 6 hours, you are sitting in front of the system. Rules of a language, very good. Nandini Sindhuja, thank you so much. Rules of a language, next. Structure of a language, Akash, a set of protocols set by a language. Kaushika, a structure of a language, very good. You are making a good attempt. You guys are amazing, right? Thank you so much. Akash. R is a set of protocols set by a language. Okay, little bit, it's okay. So, in POC, right? Again, I'll come to the definitions according to the subject, right? A formal language theory, a grammar describes how to form a strings, right? How the strings, now before that I had shown a strings, two strings, C, A, D, right? So, how that strings are formed, that for that we are going for a grammar, right? How the strings are formed, right? How to form a string, right? Exactly meaning how to form a string for a language. That is said to be a grammar. Is that clear? Is that clear? Put it in the chat box here. Yeah, Akash, yes, thank you. Swadini, Seema, okay. I'm seeing only few other people, right? Only few people are keep on chatting. Thank you so much for the cooperation. Remaining students, please be attentive, right? So that it will be really a wonderful section. See, end of the section, I'll ask the feedback from you people also. So please, informal language theory, grammar describes how to form a strings, form a language alphabet, right? So can anyone guess who's he? May not be. Last 2 days only I had seen his photo, right? I'm being 20 years experience. I had seen maybe 18th or 17th only his photo, right? Who's he? Any guesses? Say no also you can type it, right? So that I can understand your people are no idea. Karthik, thank you. No, right? Okay, so let me see, right, the person, right, Noam Chomsky, right, Chomsky hierarchy, he contributed POC as like anything, right, so we are the grammar for mathematical model is introduced by him, right, in which year, 1959, he introduced in a grammar, right, what he had proposed is mathematical model for a grammar, why he went for it, right, that question is more important. He want to pass on languages so that he found that grammar, right? So what is pass? So far you people are not familiar with compiler design, so I know what I had given definition for a pass. That's it's nothing but resolve into sentence into a small components so that we can describe a syntax rules. In detail we'll see later. So he tried to pass a language. That time he found mathematical model for a grammar that you have to understand, right? So the end result for his research is generative grammar. What is generative grammar? Recognition device. Those and all we will see detailed, right? Exactly. The grammar was introduced. Mathematical grammar was introduced by Noam Chomsky. That was the slight motive, right? So next slide we'll go, right? So now I am going to give an example simple sentence in English, right? So can you please type in a simple sentence? Anyone? Any simple sentence? Any simple sentence? 152 students only. The sentence is too high, right? Students, please, any simple sentence in English. This is TOC section. Wonderful, Sanjay sir. And next. Anyone? How are you, Hemlata? Thank you. Vignesh says, sun rises in the east. Rakesh, good morning to all. Today is Wednesday. Very good, right? Any sentence? Any sentence? We are learning theory of computation. Very good. Very good. Next, Nandini Sinduja. I had spelled out your name. Congratulations. Kaushika, this class is interesting. Thank you. Thank you so much. Right? Nice word. So, but in schools, they had named, right? Some formation, right? They had taught you how to make a sentence. Any people can remember that? Any people how to make in a sentence? They have some set of rules for it, right? Anyone guess what it is? What the rule is? I am in the chat box, right? You people has to be get into the subject, then only it will be interesting, right? So please type it. 150 participants are there, but we are getting only few. Subject, verb, object, like Rakesh, exactly, you got it. Subject plus verb plus subject, right? When you are typing the sentence, you got it or not, that you have to check it, right? A sentence should contain subject and object and the verb. Okay, right, in order they will place. Very good, very good. Keetana, Vinisha and Swati, thank you so much, Rakesh. Right, so we'll go at you people are very, very, very good at all those things, right? So SVO, right? You studied automata. That was in a sentence I had taken for SVO, right? And SV, subject and verb alone, you learn, right? And I can say noun phrase, verb phrase, the bird sings a song. In that, what is noun phrase? What is verb phrase? Please type it in the chat box. The bird sings a song. What is verb phrase? What is noun phrase? You type it in the chat box. You are 150 students. Please, people, don't sleep. The bird is now sings. Okay, verb. Okay, sings is in a verb phase, right? Verb phase, when we're going to be in a verb, it is only sings. Verb phase is containing song also, right? Sings verb, song noun. Okay, very good. Very good. Okay, you people are remembering English, right? Don't be that I am not taking too much, but understanding context-free grammars or grammar for a language, you have to. Then you will be queen of mathematical model, right? So, VO star, what is VPSR? Hemlata, I couldn't understand. Sing song, verb, verb phrase. Okay, thank you. So, this is our thing. Next will go for, so next example I had went for it, the man, because I learned from some teachers, she always took this example, so I am also writing the same thing because it's easy to remember. The man wrote a book, right? So in that, what is NP1, what is VP? That is noun phrase 1 and verb phrase. So people don't be pinched or right, bored. Please type it in the chat box. What is NP1? What is VP? What is noun phrase? What is verb phrase? The man wrote a book. Network issue, ma'am. Are you not able to listen? I'm audible. The ma'am, NP1. Okay, Vignesh. Man. The man wrote this in a verb. Okay. Swati wrote verb, okay, and peace, man. You people are missing out. Please be graceful. What is the, right? What is these are the things are very carefully after the man is a noun. Exactly, Swati, you got it, right? So all the things, this sentence is, now we human beings are not going to learn. Machine is going to learn. So everything I have to count it, even a space, right? So please be careful of phrasing the sentence, right? that is called as pars, right? That is called as pars. Before that, I don't know what is pars. These are now we are passing a sentence. The man, right, wrote a book. That was we are doing. Right? Wrote a book is in a verb phase. Very good, Vignesh. Got it, right? Because I had given on a color. There are two main categories. One is the man and wrote a book, right? So that it was divided. Shall we divide again? Is that any possible? Say yes or no. Shall we go for dividing again? Is that any possible for splitting again? Say yes or no. Yes. Yes, what it is. What it is. So we'll go. The time is going on. At least I have to cover one topic, right? So see here, I had again divided the words, right, strings into article, noun one, verb, noun phase two. Yeah, book, it is going to be in a noun phase two, right? So is that any possible? Again, you have to split that one, right? So see here. So this was in a whole thing we had divided. One single sentence, the man wrote a book, have two phrases, all right? So noun phrase and verb phrase. And again, noun phrase one will divide into article and noun. And verb phrase is divided into verb and noun phrase two. Again, noun phrase two is divided into article two and noun two. So article one is the and end one is man. Verb is write and article 2 is A, N2 is book, right? Is that clear? Is that clear? Yeah, Gayatri, thank you so much. Is that clear? Can you all see the diagram? Right? Yeah, good. Do you guys want that diagram, right? What structure it is? You already studied in somewhere. Data structures, I think. So what it is? What structure? From sentence, I had did something. What it is? Yeah, Vignesh, tree, Nandini, Shinduja, tree, Hemlata, right? It is exactly in a tree, right? So what we did, what sentence we did something that I had named it, what it is. I had named that what process we are doing within a sentence. Parse, right? So you people are new to this terminology. So again, I am telling we did parse, right? What are the things containing or what makes the sentence? So that is called as parse. And if the structure is tree, so it is going to be in a, right, parse tree or a syntax tree or in a derivation tree. I can name it as in any way, right? From S, I'm going for in a bottom for finding in a sentence, right? This is called as in a parse tree. Is it clear? Is that clear? Is that clear? Parse tree. What is parse tree? Yeah, Gayatri, thank you so much. Shreema, thank you so much. Okay, so you people learn today one terminology, what is parse tree, right? And for in a language, English language, we have learned that has to be transferred to one, right? Automated languages, that later part we'll see. This is what exactly going to be in a parse tree. And it is in a thing, right? Top down, from top, we are going for in a bottom. So top down passing also I can say, right? Parse tree or syntax tree or in a derivation tree, right? So how we made in a sentence, we'll see in a one glance, right? Next thing, you have to type it in your chat box. Sentence is divided into, the example which you have seen is the man, right, wrote a book. For that, the sentence is divided into noun phrase one and verb phrase. What is going to be in the next? What is going to be next? How we had divided next? How we divided next? Any guesses? Once again, I saw the diagram, right? Please, people, they note it down. From that only, I'm going to form on the next one, right? So please, we note it out, right? Or remember it. Nothing is very easy, example only. Shall I proceed next? Shall I proceed? Oh, yeah, Nandini Sinan exactly given. Non-phase one, verb phase, non-phase two, right? Non-phase, yeah, good. Thank you so much. You people are very interactive. Yeah, thank you. So your remaining students, please note it down, right? From that only I'm going to make an other part, right? Next terminology we are going to study. For that, this is more important, right? So See, a sentence divided into noun phrase and verb phrase. Again, it was divided, right? Any order you can take it. I had taken as, right? Noun phrase is divided into article 1 and N1, right? And the article is the. Are you following? Are you following? Is that okay? Yeah, Hemlata, thank you so much. Okay. So, article 1, again, it was derived as the. And next, N1 is men. What is left out? What is left out? Now, what we have to go for it? VP, yeah, Rakesh, thank you. Right? Verb phrase, we have to go for it. Right? So, again, verb phrase is verb plus noun phrase 2. Right? And verb is wrote. And noun phrase 2 is again divided into article 2 and N2. And article 2 is a, and N2 is an a book. Is that clear? Is that clear? Is that clear? Shima, Dekama, everyone has to. 150 students are presenting. Why very few are coming? I don't know, right? Devi, thank you, Devi. Mukashini, Sanjay, yes. Okay. I'm seeing repeated names are only 15 or 20 students are very active. What about remaining students? Students, please answer for it. Anuruth left the meeting. Why? The class is not interesting. Okay. So now we had given. I had given in two colors. Do you guess what it mean? I had given in two colors. What did it mean? Any guesses? Any guesses? Any guesses? No. Okay, no, class, not another problem. Any guesses? Any guesses? Other than Akash? Kartika Raj, no idea. Okay, see here. When I had given as in a red, it was replaced by something, right? When it is given as in a blue, it cannot be replaced. Is that okay? Is that okay? Blue strings, yeah, Sanjay Charan, you got it. But we will name it as in a different terminology here, right? Yeah, you got it. So once again, I'm repeating, in whatever I had given as in a blue, we'll have an a replacement with some other string. But when I had ended with an a blue, it doesn't have an a replacement. So what we are calling these rules is in a production rules, right? In a grammar, one component is production rules that we had clearly known. A sentence divided into noun phrase and verb phrase, noun phrase, article and noun. Article, the, na, man, verb phrase, verb plus noun phrase 2, verb is wrote. And noun phrase 2, again, article 2 and noun 2. Article 2 is a and 2 is. These are the things are rules, right? To make a sentence, right? So these are called as in a production rules in grammar, in theory of computation. And this arrow, you can call it as rewritten as, right? I can replace with something, rewritten as. Yes, it's rewritten as noun phrase 1 and verb phrase 1. And article 1 is replaced, rewritten as the. Is that clear? What is production rule? A is a string. Yeah, is a string. What is in doubt? It is another string over the length 1. Length 1. Even epsilon is an empty string, but the zero length string. Finite length, including 1. Okay. Thank you so much. Is that clear? Is that clear? Production rules, parse tree. So far we have seen parse tree, production rules. What is parsing? Right? Is that clear? Yeah, good. Thank you. So we'll go for next. So these are the things I had given. Right? See here. Okay. Sentence. Right, replaced as in noun phrase 1. Please listen. Previously, you have an a, right, single arrow. Now you see, I'm replacing. Yes, replaced with NP1. Right, I'm describing or deriving from. Yes, I'm deriving noun phase 1 and verb phase. From noun phase 1, I am deriving as article 1 and noun 1. In verb phase, I am keeping as article 1, the, and each step I am expanding or replacing with my production rules, right? So, N1, it is replaced by man, and BP is replaced with we, which are we had seen in previous rules, right? Verb and noun phase 2. Again, noun phase 2 is replaced with article 2 and N2. And N2, these are the things are replaced with the help of and the rules which we had framed before, right? And N2 is replaced by book, and article 2 is replaced with A. Is that clear? Type it in the chat box here. Yeah. Is that clear what we are doing? Previously, whatever I have seen, given us rules, production rules. Based on the production rules, I am deriving in a sentence. Is that clear? Vinisha, right. Thank you. So see here, once again, I am repeating because you should not get confused. These are the things are called as in a production rules. Based on that, from S, I am going to replace. I am going to using this rule. S can be replaced with NP1 and VP. And NP can be replaced with Article 1 and N1. These are the rules I had framed from a past tree. From past tree, I framed the rule. From the rule, I am going to derive a sentence. The man wrote a book. So, this was something. The man, right, wrote a book. I had derived from the rules. So, this is called as a derivation, right? Directly derives. So, I am deriving a sentence from a rule which we had framed earlier. So this is called as a derivation. And this double arrow, the double arrow means directly derives. And the sentences is here, no, single step, only one can be replaced, right? Only one can be replaced. See here, each space, right? S will be replaced, right? With what S is going to be NP and VP1. In this one, what I'm going to replace, right? NP1 only I'm replacing by article 1 and N1. Right, in this, what I am going to replace article 1 alone, I am going to replace, that is the in right, and then what I am going to, in this sentence, right, in this derivation, what I am going to replace N1 alone, in this sentence, what I am going to replace VP says in a single step, only one thing can be replaced. What is that thing? I will tell it later. Is that clear? Swati, okay, what about remaining 156 people? Is that clear? Derivation. Gayatri, Jwala, thank you. Devi again. Naren, right? First time I'm reading the name Naren. Thank you so much. Right? So far, what are the things we have seen? A past tree, a production rules, and then a derivation. So, past tree, a production rule, and derivation. So, these are the three things we have seen, right? So, can you find this one? Later part we'll see, right? Differences. So I had mentioned that, right? Alpha tends to beta. This is in a relationship obtained in one step, right? I can go for obtaining more relationships, right? By alpha dash tends to and putting in a star there, right? Star there. It means that more than one steps I am going to derive that. See here from sentences, that we had derived the man wrote a book. It's not in a single step we got it. More than one step we had used, so that we'll put star. Is that clear? Derivation notations. What does it mean by double arrow? Double arrow with a star. Is that clear? Okay. So, I had told you, before that two colors, right? We had told you the one color will have replacement and the another color doesn't have a replacement. The noun and verb is rewritten as something, right? That is replaced by something. So, that is called as a non-terminal N. Non-terminal N. The man wrote a book cannot be rewritten. That's all, right? That is another thing. Someone had mentioned that it's going to be in a strings, right? Exactly, they are strings, right? But if the string is here, it is called as in a terminal. From there, we cannot replace, right? Terminal end point, right? So we have two terminologies seen before, non-terminal that will have a replacement that will be replaced by some other strings, right? So that is called as non-terminal. Notation for that is N. and something we cannot replace, that's all. From there it is going to be stopped there, right? That is called as a terminal. And we can have total alphabet, it is nothing but the notation we can say is V. It is N union T, right? Non-terminal union T is called as V, total alphabet. Together, non-terminal and terminal is called as total alphabet. Is that clear? Shreema, KR, other than that? Koshik, Gayatri, yes ma'am, thank you, right. So another part, we started from a sentence. Usually, grammar has to start from a start symbol, and it is also one of a non-terminal. Please remember, start symbol is one of none because it has a replacement. Start symbol has to be replaced, right? So it is a non-terminal, and it has to start from a start symbol. And sentential form is V, sir. What is V? Non-terminal union with terminal, right? So that is V star. And production rules, I had shown you a production rule. Sentence, how S will be replaced, how NP will be replaced, how these are the things are called as rule. So these are the four terminologies are more important which define grammars. Non-terminal N, terminal T, and S, and then P, right? So formal definitions we will see, right? People please note it down, this is more important. Now we have seen the definition. Yeah, grammar G can be formally written as four tuples, right? G, that is N, T, S, P. N is in a set of non-terminal symbols, T is in a set of terminal symbols, and S is in a start symbol, P is in the production rules for terminals and non-terminals. Is that clear? See, once again I am repeating. G defined as NTPS, usually we'll delete as NTPS, but formally NTSP, right? So N is a set of non-terminal which has a replacement. A symbol will have a replacement, right? A terminal which doesn't have a replacement. S is a start symbol, belongs to a non-terminal. And P is a production symbol. Like finite automata, a grammar is defined with four tuples. Is it clear? Is it clear? Definition of a grammar. So can you please type it as what is N? We'll have a quick recap, right? What is N? And seeing that also you can type. What is N? Non-terminal, Gayatri AE, fastest girl, Swati N, Kausika, okay, what is N? Non-terminal symbol, okay, Rakesh, okay, non-terminal. What about remaining people? What is N? Kartik Raj, non-terminal, okay. Remaining people, I'm seeing the thing, you can say. I am putting the slide for your reference, right? Just seeing that you are typing. Kartik Raj, after that, what is N? Okay, let's we go for the next one. Only 5 or 6 people are typing, yeah, right? 155 only there, but only 5 students are typing. Remaining students, please type it. Next question, next fastest student in your class, we'll see. What is going to be T? Terminal, first one, Vignesh, yeah. Chala, Keetana, Challa Maulika, that is the first time, Challa Maulika, wow, okay. Thank you, terminal. We'll see, Kritika V, right? Okay, thank you. Remaining people also started answering, very good. Shall I ask next? What is in a start symbol, right? Start symbol is belongs to terminal or non-terminal? Start symbol is belongs to terminal or non-terminal? Start symbol belongs to non-terminal or terminal? Capital N, yeah, right? Non-terminal, very good, right? What is V? No, P, I'm not audible, V, I am asking, V for van, total alphabet, right, total alphabet means terminal and non-terminal together, right, okay, very good, okay, quickly you type it, grammar consists of four tuples, what are the four tuples, grammar considered about for NTSP. Okay, NTSP, 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 Hemlata, NTSP, NTSP. Only yes. Anushari, M, NTSP, NTSP. Okay. So G is NTSP. That you have to remember, right? The definition of an grammar. Okay. Nice girls, very good, very good, right? So next we'll go for an exercise, right? It is going to be 9:30, right? Quickly you take a paper or other thing, right? You have to draw past three for these two, right? And you have to write production rules and you have to derive, right? These are the three things you have to do it for these two examples. Quick, fast, and you can put it as in a snapshot or you can share a screen. If you've taken a Photoshop, you can share it, right? Quickly do. So for this two things, you have to complete your exercise. Please students, please practice this, then only you can understand very well. If you understand that this unit is completely thoroughly, you can do it, right? And up to your PhD. So please do it in your notebook. For these two sentences, draw past three, right? And then derivation, production rule. First, you have to go for production rule, then only you can derive. Without the production rule, you cannot derive. So, construct a past three, write a productions, write a derivation. And then take a snapshot and then share it with the screen. So for the next class, probably on Friday, I need answers. Maybe I'll be added with your WhatsApp group or something, or in Google Classroom, you can post this as an assignment. Take a picture and post it, right? That's I need it, right? So you have to do three things for these two examples. Once again, I'm repeating, past three, and then production rules and derivation, right? These are three things along with definition of a grammar today we had learned. That is in a conclusion for this today's class. Thank you so much, girls and boys, right? It's in a wonderful section, interactive section. Hope remaining students also be very interactive for the next classes. Anyone can give a feedback in the chat box. How was the class? When everyone is doing within a paper, no problem. Sanjay Charan has left the meeting. Okay. Left the meeting. Anyone can give a feedback if you are alive, right? How was the class? Wonderful interaction. Thank you. Thank you, Vignesh. Thank you so much. All right. Inform to other students, this is an interesting subject. You can learn a lot. Inform to your presence. The class was very impactful. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. All right. Now we can have, it was understandable, mom. Thank you. Very interactive section. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Okay. Thank you all, right? Thank you.